Good morning, guys. Okay, fifth grade. Pay attention, please. Fifth grade, children meaning the earth. Okay. Give me a second, please. Open your workbook on page number 84, please. Open your workbook on page number 84. On the page number 84, we are going to read about children mending the earth. Okay. Every 2 years, the United Nations holds the Tunza International Children's Conference to teach children to keep the earth healthy. The children learn to mend the damage done to the earth by older people. One young girl from the USA saw people dumping garbage on the lawn across from her house. She was so upset that she wanted to do something. The smell of the garbage was so bad and that her family couldn't hardly breathe. She was so sad that she wanted to cry. She knew that everyone had to clean up the land. She started a cleanup project with the help of the landowner. In a few years, the old dump became a beautiful park with large trees. Those trees gave shade to children who often played under the trees. This showed that it would be so easy for anyone to make a difference. The question you must ask yourself is, could you play a part in saving the earth too? Even a small effort could help us, the earth. Okay, guys. Today we are going to recognize this beautiful story. Vamos a hablar acerca de niños que reparan la tierra, ¿verdad? Menciona ahí que la tierra cada 2 años, dice que cada 2 años las Naciones Unidas celebran la Conferencia Internacional de Niños, TUNSA, para enseñar a los niños a mantener la tierra sana. Sé que los niños aprenden a reparar el daño causado a la tierra por las personas mayores. Aquí cuenta que una joven de Estados Unidos vio a personas tirando basura en el terreno frente a su casa y la chica estaba tan molesta porque... estaba tan molesta que ella quería hacer algo. Dice que el olor de la basura era tan malo que su familia apenas podía respirar. Ella estaba tan triste que quería llorar. Así que ella comenzó un proyecto de limpieza con ayuda de propietarios de la tierra. En pocos años, dice que el antiguo vertedero ese de pura basura que tiraban las personas se convirtió en un hermoso parque con grandes árboles. Esos árboles daban sombra, ¿verdad?, a los niños que a menudo jugaban bajo esos árboles. Esto demuestra, chicos, de que sería muy fácil para cualquiera marcar la diferencia. La pregunta aquí es, la pregunta que uno puede hacerse es, ¿podrías tú también contribuir a salvar a la Tierra? Y dice que incluso un pequeño esfuerzo podría ayudarnos a salvar a la Tierra. Ok, guys. Ajá. And now we are going to read some questions. For example, number one. What does the Tunza International Children's Conference teach children? O sea, número uno, ¿qué enseña a los niños la Conferencia Internacional de Tunza que vimos allí? ¿Qué les enseña? A ver. Melanie.
Teacher les enseña a cuidar la tierra.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Okay, guys, let's go to Ryder. I need another color. Yes. They teach children to keep the earth healthy. Y a mantenerla también saludable, a tener la tierra saludable. It's correct. Thank you so much. Number two. Question number two. What do children learn for the Tunza International Children's Conference? ¿Qué aprenden los niños de la Conferencia Internacional Infantil de Tunza? ¿Qué aprenden ellos también? ¿Qué es lo que, cuál es el problema con la tierra? Jonathan, please.
Y el que se contamina, y entonces los niños me imagino que lo tienen que recoger. Como lo dice la muchacha, porque lo que hoy usted dijo es que ella vio un vertedero cerca de su casa, y entonces ella, me imagino que él lo limpió y hizo un parque y plantó muchos árboles.
Yes, it's correct. Thank you so much. But remember, guys, what is the beginning to the story? Al principio de la historia, ustedes van a encontrar allí parte de la respuesta también. Thank you, Jonathan. Remember, what is the problem? I'm gonna write there. Listen to me, please, everybody. Okay. Mm-hmm. The children learn to mend the damage done the earth by older people. Recuerden que el problema también viene de las personas mayores. No puedo creer que una niña tan pequeña se diera cuenta de eso. Meanwhile, the older people create a damage, I think so. Problema está en nosotros, las personas mayores, que somos los que nos encargamos de dañar el planeta, tirando colillas de cigarrillo, cerveza, lata de soda, basura, el chihuí que me como, vaya para allá. I love because all time when I leave out to my home, when I leave, my backpack is full of garbage all time. I put the garbage into my bag or my purpose Not time I'm walking beautiful for the street, but if I eat in something, I put in into my bag or my purpose, I put my things, my garbage there. Siempre que salgo a la calle, mis bolsas están llenas de basura. Cuando llego a la casa, empiezo a depurar. Me como un chihui, va a la bolsa. Me como esto, va a la bolsa. Ahora he optado por conseguir un cartucho, tener un cartucho siempre adentro para meter allí, diferenciarlo de lo demás. Porque a veces la meto en el bolsillito y si eso mancha, se me mancha la bolsa. Pero cuido. No me como algo y vaya y lo tiro por ahí. Y si yo tiro algo y me cae por fuera, no sé, de repente sale fuera de la basura, me inclino y lo recojo otra vez. Y lo tiro en la basura. Porque no me gusta. No me gusta. Number three. What was so bad about the garbage dump? La pregunta aquí sería, ¿qué fue? ¿Qué tenía de malo ese basurero? ¿Cuál era el problema con el basurero, el vertedero? Ana, Jonathan nos dijo una parte, but tell me.
De que tenía muy mal olor y la familia apenas podía respirar.
Thank you so much. Ajá, ajá, thank you so much. And Jonathan, he told us the girl's family called Hurley Bread. De milagro podía respirar apenas, ¿no? Hombre, yo no hubiese soportado eso. Qué barbaridad. Breathe, breathe. Lo voy a poner por acá porque no veo aquí el... Yes. Dice, the smell from the garbage dump was so bad that the girl's family could hardly breathe. Why did the young girl from the USA start a cleanup project? ¿Por qué la joven de Estados Unidos inició un proyecto de limpieza? Why? She did start a clean up project. Do you remember? Melanie?
Para tener el planeta limpio.
Thank you. Es algo bastante parecido a lo que ella respondió. Thank you so much. Excellent. Let me write here. Workbook. Page number 84. Is correct, Melanie. She knew that everyone had to clean up the land. Ella se dio cuenta o supo de que todos, no solamente uno, teníamos que limpiar el planeta, tener limpia la tierra. What does this story teach you? What does this story teach you? ¿Qué le enseña a usted esta historia? Ana?
The each of us have to take care of the planet and not litter.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Can you repeat? I don't remember. Can you repeat, please?
That each of us have to take care of the planet and not lead it.
Okay, thank you so much. Melanie?
Teacher, que no debemos botar basura por las calles.
Yes.
Que si hay basura debemos recogerla y tirarla en el tinaco.
Okay, it's correct. Es un buen punto. But the reason in this story is on the down part and the end to the story. Al final de la historia se encuentra la parte clave. ¿Qué debemos hacer? Ya terminando la parte verde de la historia. Cuando dice, después de la pregunta, the question you must ask yourself is, could you play a part in saving the earth too? ¿Qué dice al final? Even a small. A ver. ¿Quién lo lee? Melanie, please.
Even a small effort could help us save the earth.
Thank you. Yes, it's correct. It's correct. It's correct. Go help us. Yes. Un pequeño esfuerzo podría ayudar a salvar el planeta. Puede hacerlo. Puede hacerlo. Okay, guys. Don't forget the children mending the earth. ¿Cómo hay que cuidar el planeta? I love the story about this girl, to young girl from the USA. I think she's smart. Because maybe I think she doesn't light the garbage on the floor. And however she started that project. Okay, and it's good. It's good. I think maybe in Panama, the garbage is a big problem here. Lo mismo que sucede aquí en Panamá. La basura siempre ha sido un problema grave, que no recogen la basura a tiempo, que la basura huele mal, que la basura tira un juguito, que ese juguito huele feo. Cuando tú pasas cerca de ese juguito, Padre de Gloria, Dios Santo, ayúdame. Okay, guys, let's continue, please. Open your workbook on page number 85. And now you're going to help me, please. Okay, listen. Ooh. Open your workbook on page number 85. On the page number 85, we are going to do many activity here, and you are going to help me, please. Okay, listen to me. Complete the following mind map, right? Kelly went to bed late last night. Kelly's day. Kelly went to bed last night. So what is the first? Okay, I'm gonna write here in that part. Voy a escribir en la parte de afuera. Ustedes lo van a colocar allí porque aquí para ver. Aunque yo puedo. Tendría que ponerlo chiquitito. Espero que lo vean, chicos. Ajá. Kelly went to bed last night, so she missed. Este color no me gusta. She missed. The bus to school. Okay, next. She ran. To a school. And she didn't have breakfast at home. She was so careless that she forgot to bring her backpack and homework. Remember, she was late and she ran to school and she forgot to bring her backpack and homework. Okay. Next. Melanie, tell me.
Teacher, no importa que nos salgamos de las líneas.
No, no problem. No problem. She had to finish. She had to finish all her work before she went to bed. Uh-huh. Her mother yelled out. Yell at, recuerden que ayer les decía de las tres formas de gritar. Her mother yelled at. La número uno era scream out, y la otra era shout out. Y la última es yell at, ese es gritar también. Her mother yelled at her when she got home. She go home after school. Okay. Complete the pre-writing exercise chart. Topic sentence, supporting sentence, and closing sentence. Okay. And now you're going to write here. Kelly had a what? A terrible day today. Because bad is not correct. A terrible. Okay, and now you are going to write here that part, all part, and you are going to write down, right? For example, Kelly went to bed is the first. Vamos a usar todas las partes de arriba para ir llenando abajo. Kelly went to bed last night, so she missed the bus. She missed the bus to school. Si me salgo, bueno, chicos, ya saben que me salí aquí. Number two, o sea, que indica que usted tiene que escribir más chiquito todavía. She ran to school and she didn't. She didn't have breakfast at home. Sorry for her. It was a terrible day. She was so careless that she forgot to bring her backpack and homework. She had to finish all her homework, her work before she went to bed. Her mother yelled at her when she got home after school. Okay, but we need to change something here. Aquí hay dos cosas que hay que cambiar. Okay, I know she ran. I know she ran. She ran to school and didn't have a breakfast at home, right? She was careless, is correct, and her mother is first because she finished. Okay, I think the cycle began, or start one more time. Pienso que tal vez el ciclo comenzó, porque vemos que ella fue tarde en la noche a la cama, o sea, se acostó muy tarde, llegó tarde a la escuela, perdió el, corrió detrás del autobús, no tuvo desayuno. Fue descuidada porque olvidó llevar su lonchera, su mochila y su tarea. Su mamá le gritó cuando llegó a la casa, le gritó a ella y ella tuvo que terminar entonces su tarea antes de ir a la cama. Ok, we are going to closing. Ok, this is a retelling, guys. This is a short retelling because we have a topic. Second, we have a body and we have the conclusion. The closing sentence are: Kelly needs to go to sleep earlier so she won't have a terrible day. Cuando yo les hablaba a ustedes de retelling, era esto lo que me refería. Un retelling comienza con, primero, una introducción, que es el tema. ¿Cuál es el tema? Kelly had a terrible day today. El cuerpo, que comenta todo lo que le pasó a Kelly. Y la conclusión, que nos enseña esa historia. Kelly needs to go to sleep earlier, so she won't have a terrible day. También podríamos usar, Kelly needs to go to sleep early because she won't have a terrible day. Ella necesita ir temprano a la cama para, porque ella no quiere tener un día malo y para que no se le repita el ciclo. Okay, on part C, you are going to write using the mind map chart above and write a paragraph about Kelly's day. All things here you need to write down because it's the story completely. For example, Kelly had a terrible day. She went to bed late last night. So she missed the bus to school and she was playing video games. Esta es una parte que nosotros no sabíamos qué pasó. She was playing video games until it was very late. Se puso a jugar videojuegos y era muy tarde. She ran to school and didn't have a breakfast at home. She forgot to bring her backpack and homework because she was so careless when she left her house. Her mother yelled at her when she got home after school. Her mother made her finish all the work before she went to bed. Kelly needs to go to sleep early so she won't have a terrible day again. Terrible day, sorry. Aquí entonces ustedes terminarían, en vez de ponerle day, antes del day le pondrían again. ¿Por qué le pondrían again? Porque ese es el final para que ella, o la conclusión de que no queremos que, o sea, no, ella no quiere que le pase lo mismo otra vez, entonces ella necesita dormir temprano. ¿Ok? You have an example. If you don't finish, go to YouTube channel, guys. It's not a problem here, right? So let's continue and I said thank you. Thank you so much.